We've got the two kayaks on there now. Thank you to Gabe for the second one right there. We've never taken that out, so don't know how that will be. We're taking a lot of new gear. So it's definitely another test run part two. Not taking that car since it broke down last time, and it's been acting a bit weird. So there it is, there's the setup. We're all ready to set sail. Hopefully, the only updates between here and then will be about traffic and not about kayak flying off or another broken down car. But we'll definitely have to see how it goes. All right, here we go. Look at all those nice little lights. Hopefully none of them turn on while we're driving. With the cars that we have though, you never really know. All right, so Theo Kevin's getting in right now. That's him. This is the setup for today. Now we've got these Danielson boxes, sinking float line this time. Still the paddle holders on the side, a jig this time with a swim bait. That's my net. The Hummingbird fish finder, then the pulley. I've got everything either bungeed down or tied down somehow. Except for the water bottle, so. Took out that rail blazer mount, that was horrible. Now I'm using that Yak Attack one. It's sprinkling a bit, so I don't know if I'm gonna end up using the mount because it might just end up getting really, really wet. All right, Theo Kevin's out there. I think I'm gonna go catch up to him. So I realized that the GoPro video may be a bit fuzzy, a bit blurry because there's definitely some raindrops on there, but that's okay. We don't need quality, I just need to be able to tell the story. So Theo Kevin's already drifting off way over there. I think I'm gonna try to put this fish finder in the water. So the transducer seems to be doing better this time. The Hummingbird's still turning on, so we'll see how it goes. I actually brought the Allen wrench this time. That way, if I do need to tighten it, I can. I should have thought of bringing all these tools last time, but I just didn't want to bring too much. And it's not even like it's that much. One thing I also did was I put another Scotty deck mount right over here. And I wanted that for my extra rod since last time I lost the line for my rod. So I'd have the extra rod over there. And I actually put it a bit closer this time, so that instead of my pulley being the thing on the mount all the way at the end, I could have the pulley a bit closer. That way I could more easily take out these crab traps. So those are some of the improvements I made. I also reeled up for the first time ever my own fishing rod. And I also rigged mine and Theo Kevin's rods. So we'll see how those go. I think I did pretty well. YouTube's amazing for like different tutorials on how to do all these things. It's really nice. So while we were coming in, there were two kayakers coming out, and one of them asked if we were going in, and we said yes. And he said that it was getting really choppy, all the kayakers have come back in, but as we were setting up to go out, another kayaker came out and said it was crystal clear calm out there. So, don't know what to think. There's some guys over here with some like really long kayaks. They're going super fast. Yeah, hit the bottom and then bring it up a bit and then just small little bounces. Did you hit the bottom? Okay. So Theo Kevin's jigging on like a squid setup I have for him. He got his permit yesterday, a one-day fishing license. So we're trying to make the most of it. First crab trap's going in right now. I know you guys probably can't see anything. because that screen looks pretty wet. But I did a butterfly coil and a mono knot. Mono knot seems a lot stronger than the last knot I was using. Can't really remember the name. But we're at 30 feet and it looks pretty rocky down below. Hopefully I don't get any line tangled. First trap's going in, I just rigged it. Long's away. And the sinking line should make this nice and easy. First time putting out a Danielson crab trap. I usually use the ring. And I marked the waypoint so I should be able to find it. Gonna test this reel out. I don't know if it's gonna work. Yo, what if this line just comes out all over again? I don't think I have enough weight on there to actually get it down. So I'm just gonna be pulling it. So the rain just stopped. I cleaned up the lens a little bit so it should be clear. I don't think it's gonna start sprinkling again, but it might. We're gonna move a bit deeper into like 40, 50 feet of water. Because over here it's just around 20. So I'm just bringing up the swim bait I put on here. I put the larger swim bait just so that it goes to the bottom faster and hopefully it attracts bigger fish rather than smaller fish that might go after it. Yeah, check this out. This is the swim bait I'm using. Just your standard swim bait, but I've never used one of these before, so. We're paddling straight out. Just over there, just like straight that way, there looks to be a lot of waves, like a lot of huge waves. So I'm gonna try to avoid that. And I'm not that comfortable with this kayak yet, so I'm trying to stay in close to the jetty. That way, if anything goes wrong, I know I can swim back and hopefully I won't lose all my gear. The swell's pretty nice today. It's not too bad. It's just over there. There are some huge waves. I don't even know what that is. Like it must come up or something there. But yeah, it's pretty big. I think we're gonna check the crab pots in 20 minutes. I don't know exactly how long it will take these crab to get in, but usually if there's crab there, it won't take them that long. So. Like I know some people soak for like an hour, hour and a half, or 3 hours, but we're not doing that today. And then if there's nothing in there, then yeah, we'll let them soak for longer next time. But I have a feeling that there's gonna be some in there. Tons of jellyfish over here. The GoPro might be muffled. Right here, I'll just dip the GoPro in. Try to get this video. Okay. I think Teal Kevin's gonna get that trap. We're gonna get the trap right here. This pool is nice to not get anything tangled. And then it definitely helps, like with the weight. Just so you don't have all that rope coming off. Anything? No, it doesn't look like much. All right, two rock crab. Not that big though. Pretty small. So me, I just cast it, and then all of a sudden it just starts tangling like crazy. I don't even know what I did, but I just cut randomly and it seems to have worked out in my favor. So I'm just gonna rig this again. Probably use something smaller because I haven't got anything on the big one. And I kind of wasn't expecting to. So all this concentrating on just one tiny object while you're like going around these waves, I'm starting to feel sick. Okay, so I just rigged up a fixed squid. We'll see if that does any better than the swim bait I have. Still kind of big. I'm trying to aim for some smaller fish here. See, I'm not gonna cast again because last time I cast it, it just did not end up well. I think I got something. No way, I literally just finished putting in the battery for the GoPro. And I think I caught something. Yeah, I caught something. Okay. I was not prepared for this. Whoa. Whoa. Yeah, that thing's going down. It's going down. Whoa. I don't really know the tension settings though. But I've got it around like 12 feet down, 11 feet down. Have I been in the same spot the whole time?
I think so.
Maybe it is caught on something then. Yeah, I was just caught on something. Oh.
So close.
I think it's just because I'm used to if I'm like getting the resistance and it's changing, I'm used to that being a fish.
Yeah.
But on a kayak, if it's changing, yeah, that might just mean you're like on the wave going up and down.
Yeah.
Man, I was really just fighting weeds here for like 5 minutes. All right, Theo Kevin's bringing up this first crab trap of ours. The swell is kind of choppy over here, so we're gonna try not to get flipped over. Let's see. Oh!
Oh! Oh, wow!
This one's a catch. Nice! Oh no! There's one just fell!
That was too small.
Alright, oh no! Two just fell! Jeez!
Two just fell?
Yeah, they just fell right under. But these are some good sized crab. First pot looks good.
Oh no!
What happened?
The other one fell. It went out the side.
How?
I don't know. It just went out the side. I wasn't watching. I was paying attention.
All right.
Let's get these things before they get up.
Yeah, we're having a bunch of crab just fall off. That was a good catch. Yeah, I think the ones that just fell out were good size too. I don't know how they're falling out though.
They look like they're stuck and then they just fall out. There you go.
All right. Got our four crab.
Valiant fight. Okay, now we gotta be super careful when we pull up this other one.
Okay. So that last trap we got in was not filled. It just had like three keepers. So we kept those three. The swell was kind of building up, so it kind of made getting the traps out hectic. The first one, man, let me just tell you that if you're getting the Danielson trap for rock crab, the little holes on the side, the whole like mesh cage, it just lets out everything. And I think that it might just be made just for Dungeness, because that first one we pulled up like five keepers and it was just letting everything out. There's way too much space for it. So definitely don't get the Danielson crab cage if you're trying to go for rock crab. Like when he brought it up, two just fell out. And then later when he had it on the kayak, another one fell out. So, but we still got a good amount. I think we got like 6 or 7 rock crab. We'll make a nice meal. Have that with some bread. definitely hungry. When the fog rolls in over here, it's pretty crazy. It's like you can't see anything. I don't know if you can see behind me, but it's all like white. Oh, this video must look cool. I think next time if I come out here to crab, I'm gonna bring my two rings, because those ones you don't have to wait as long, since the crab immediately know that they're there and there's no like doors that they need to get through. So it's really easy for them to figure out how to get in, because there's no mechanism of keeping them in. And if these crab cages aren't capable of keeping the rock crab in, then there's no point in using a cage that's meant to keep them in for hours after they get in. So, it's been a good trip. We're going back in. Theo Kevin's way in front of me. But, oh man. The ocean is awesome. The ocean is pretty nice. It can be scary though. So right over here to my left, I wish that I wasn't paddling so I could show you. Maybe you'll get it in the side. But to my left, there's like the last part of the jetty that no one ever goes on. It's like covered in white rocks. White rocks are just because of a ton of bird poop. And these birds look like they're chilling. They're just chilling on there. So, Theo Kevin like left me far behind. And I was wondering, why am I going so slow? You know? I tend to go faster. But, because I was trying to race him and he didn't know that. But, yeah, I was like, why am I going so slow? Like, what's causing me to slow down so much? And just the crabs in the water in the mesh bag slowed me down so much. Which is kind of surprising. I didn't expect that. And now I'm like going at 3.5 miles per hour versus like before. So much different.
Check out the fog.
Literally nothing around. Look at that, just fog. Looks pretty cool.